Stokes has achieved is so special, so unique, it can inspire every young person in the country.
I wasn't sure where I was seen to fit into the team until that test match. Got smacked everywhere, lost the World Cup for England. It could have gone one way or the other there, and it was either like let it chew you up and spit you out and then on you go, but you know, just took it as a lesson. You know, you're only as good as the next game. First game was actually, we call it pie and peas. It was on a Wednesday. Well, I was like 13, 14. I bowled a bouncer at an old guy with no helmet on and he kicked off at me because I bowled him a bouncer. And I was like, well, it's not my fault. You're stupid because you don't have a helmet on. I wasn't bothered that he was like a fully grown man like, trying to have a go at me. That could have been easy to just to sort of like go into my shell and just turn around and be like, well, yeah, he's probably right. But I was like, nah, it's not my problem. Just stand up to it, I guess. In 2015, at Lords against New Zealand, Fabi just took over and I was sort of in and out of the team.
Again, you cannot bowl there, Ben Stokes. What a lovely 50. Well played, young man, especially with England in trouble.
Yes, absolutely. He's a game changer.
Obviously, I played games before that, but it was so just sort of in and out.
It's 50 to Ben Stokes. It's been a really forthright innings as well.
Oh, he's hit that. He's walloped that out of the park. This is how we and both of them occasionally played.
I wasn't sure where I was seen to fit into the team.
There it is. Fantastic moment for Ben Stokes. A seam-stealing, scintillating 100. That's the fastest Test 100 ever made at Lords.
See what this game can do to you. One of the great things you'll ever see.
Stokes came out and played as well as I've ever seen really anyone play.
Since that game, you know, I'd been consistent in the team. That game, for me, I look back on and that's almost like the start of my Test career, that Test match against New Zealand at Lords. Eden Gardens, 2016, T20 World Cup final. So, yeah, it was quite a big moment, that. Smacked everywhere, lost the World Cup for England. It could have either gone one way or the other there and it was either like let it chew you up and spit you out and then on you go, but you know, just took it as a lesson. To be honest, I just don't even really give it a second thought unless ICC tweet 4 years ago to the day that Carlos Brathwaite did this to Ben Stokes, so there we go again, so yeah. everything from there was just like, go forward, don't reminisce about that, because you know, you're only as good as your next game. World Cup final, that made me realise that, you know, that's a singular moment, but everything I had put into the 4 years building up to that was all for that one game. If I'd been in that situation 2 years earlier, you know, I don't think I would have had the thought processes that I went through on that day, and I definitely wouldn't have been able to go out in that Super Over because I was nowhere near as fit. Take your games as they come and go, but it's not just as simple as turning up and, you know, hoping to perform. You know, there's so much work that goes into one single moment, and I think looking back on that, I can look back at everything that I went through in the 4 years with the one day team as a person, as a team, really made me realize that, you know, all this hard work that, you know, we've put in behind the scenes as a team and as an individual, like, really counted towards that.